Hello everybody, welcome to the Python math section. In this video, I'm going to discuss the way to do the Russian peasant multiplication. So this multiplication technique involves halving one number and doubling another number continuously. And when we do the halving, when it is an odd number, we just take the quotient. And when the halved value becomes 1, we stop the halving and doubling. And that means the process stops. And we are going to delete the number pair when the halving value is even. So I'm going to explain the idea with one example. So suppose I want to do the multiplication of 12 and 13. Now 12 is continuously halved, while 13 is continuously doubled. And we can see the second row that halving 12 gives me 6, and doubling 13 gives me 26. And on the third row, we can see that halving 6 gives me 3, and doubling 26 gives me 52. And when I want to do the halving of 3, I just take the quotient, which is simply equal to 1. And on the second number, the doubling gives me 104. And when the halving value becomes 1, I will stop the further halving and doubling. Okay, when the halving and doubling stop, we can try to delete the row that has an even number in the halving number. So we delete the first row in which the number to be halved is even. And we also delete the second row in which the number to be halved is even. So we just remain the third and the fourth row. And we simply add up the second numbers coming from the doubling side. And in this case, we have 52 plus 104. To get 156 as the answer of the multiplication of 12 and 13. So that's the idea of the Russian peasant multiplication. Now, let us see the implementation of the Russian peasant multiplication. So in this case, I have to accept two numbers from the user input. When I use the split method, I'm going to just separate the two integers coming from the user input to variables called A and B, respectively. And then I just turn the value coming from A and B to integers. Initially, the input function just gives me some strings. In order to manipulate the numbers instead of the strings, I have to turn the strings into integers. And then I want to save the result. So suppose I set the result to be 0 first. After some manipulation, I'm able to update the result to be the product of the two numbers A and B. Now we have to make sure that the number to be halved is at least 1. So I have to check this condition. Suppose A is the number to be halved, I have to make sure that A has to be larger than 0 or at least equal to 1, okay? Okay, what does it mean by this one? If the modulus operation gives me a non-zero value, it just means that A, or the value to be halved, is an odd number. If A is an odd number, I just add the doubling value to the result. And then I have to update the values of A and B. Okay. B has to keep doubling, and A has to keep dividing by 2. So here I use integer division so that I just take care of the quotient instead of the decimal number coming from the division. Okay, after that, I can simply print out the result. So now the program is complete, and let me try some examples. So suppose I have 15 and 18, I will get the answer as 270. So it is quite easy to understand why it gives me this case. And how about the case when A is an even number and B is an odd number? We can see another example. (16 × 45) = 720. So the basic idea is simply coming from the illustration at the beginning of the video. We keep deleting the row with the halving number being an even number, okay? And we will get the result by adding the doubling numbers at the end of the doubling and halving process. So we can see that the Russian peasant multiplication is quite simple to implement. The idea is just inside the while loop here. And we have to check that the halving number has to be at least 1. If it is not the case, I don't do any further halving of the number. Okay. And also we have to keep doubling the second value of your multiplication. So we keep doubling and we keep halving by taking the integer division. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.